Sharing truths in an honest and safe space where everyone can speak up and say exactly what's on their mind has been one of my priorities. And on this show, I have welcomed and nurtured self-love by showing new perspectives and self-care tips from people who have invested so much into putting themselves first that they have no time for hate and self-doubt. These are their stories of change, inspiration, and everything in between. And I hope that talking about it helps you realize that everything you want is on the other side of your insecurities and fears. So join in on the conversation. This is The Talk with Tricia Centenaro. What do you perceive self-love and self-care to be?
For me, self-love is taking care of yourself and knowing that you are first. I have the thinking that first of all, you have to love yourself in order to love others. Mm-hmm. You cannot be loving other people when you don't have enough love for yourself.
Do you meditate? You seem like someone who would meditate.
I do meditate, you do? Yes. I need it in my life.
Yeah.
And sometimes life gets too crazy, especially now with my baby. I have my 9-year-old. I have my business. I have this thing that I don't know why I'm like, I want to do everything by myself. I don't like help. I'm super handsome with everything. So yeah. I do really need to meditate, yes.
Because you run your business. I know that you are the one who runs it. You go to work every day, you do everything, the ordering, the designing, everything. And then I know that Danda, your 9-year-old, and Kenzo, your 2-month-old, you don't have any nannies, no yayas.
We don't want
it's
yayas.
It's just you
yes.
and Hideo, and you don't have drivers. I see you guys, on. If anybody yes. follows you on social media, there's that 7:30 Instagram story
yes.
of usually you and Hideo singing with Danda in the back, mm-hmm. getting ready for school. Tell me about your mom.
Well, it's not my mom. It's like people in general where I grew up. Like mm-hmm. people is not attached to how you look, how you dress, how you act. Like you just be yourself. Mm-hmm. Like why are you gonna be so poised and so like made up? And, mm-hmm. for other people to look at you, it makes no sense. Are you comfortable with yourself?
Mm-hmm.
That's what you have
so
to.
So if you want to be poised and you want to look a certain way and be a certain way, you do it for yourself.
Exactly.
That's how you were raised. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
That's such a great message for girls to listen to and to live by, because I think that there are a lot of girls these days who have problem with self-worth, with self-love, with self-respect. Mm-hmm. And it's purely because, yes, they're comparing themselves too much, but we are in a comparing society. So let's go to having a new baby.
Mm-hmm.
So Kenzo's 2. You have this new bundle of joy. I mean, my daughter's 9 months old, so I feel where you are.
You know it, right?
I'm sure. There are sleepless nights. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of nappy changing. There's a lot of feeding. Are you direct feeding?
Yes.
Are you mixed feeding?
No, I'm
you're
full
direct
on breastfeeding.
Feeding.
Yeah.
I'm sure there's not much time for yourself and for your partner. But are you okay with that for now?
I'm super okay. I'm
yeah.
so happy. I'm enjoying so much. Like even the nappy changing, like the non-sleeping, everything. I love it. I love it.
Do you get much help from Hideo, your husband?
He helps me a lot. Like
yeah.
sometimes we even fight to see who's going to
no,
stay
I
with him.
I want to do it. I want to do it.
Yes. he's the best father. Like he was really born to be a father. He's
yeah.
amazing. He's
nice.
Amazing.
And
yeah.
you guys have, wait, you guys got married last year, am I right?
We got married last
yeah,
year.
Yeah, but you've been together for like
11.
Over a decade. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Congratulations. You mm-hmm. had a really big last 12 months.
Yes. Yes, we were like 10 years, like nothing much, like nothing special. Of course, it's always special, but we didn't have like any
yeah.
like. And then all of a sudden, in 1 year, we decided to get married. We had a second child.
When it comes to your 9-year-old daughter, are there values that you're trying to install in her when it comes to self-love and
oh
and
yes
self-care?
All the time.
Yeah, tell me, because I have a 9-month-old girl.
Every
so
day.
Sometimes I think to myself, oh my gosh, I hope and I pray that my daughter will have as much confidence as me. You know, my partner's always saying to me, wow Trish, you know, you have a lot of confidence. Because sometimes I'll be in the shower and I'll be singing and I'll be dancing. And I haven't lost all of my baby weight. And mm-hmm. she's 9 months old and I'm still about 8 kilos out from where I was. But it's okay. You know?
It's okay. And you look beautiful, by the way.
Thank you. Thank you. And I'm here and I'm back on camera and I'm doing the show and everything. Exactly. And it's all about self-love. And yes, I have had some of those people turn to me and say, some of those haters on social media and say, you know, how did you get your own show again? You know, you aren't as gorgeous as you were before. And it's like, huh? Like who? You definitely aren't our demographic for the show. But maybe they are. Maybe they're the kind of people who should be watching the show to love themselves more, you know, because I think jealousy is such a huge...
Exactly, and that's what's wrong with society. they put all the physical stuff on top. Like, mm-hmm. for example, if they tell you that, they wouldn't, like, see, like, you're smart, you're funny, mm-hmm. you know how to be present on camera. It's not just, like, how you, like, oh, I'm skinny, I can present a show, mm-hmm. or I can do this, I can do that. No, there is so much more above mm-hmm. that. And these people, they cannot see it. Mm-hmm. For example, when people tell me like I must be anorexic or I'm not like a good example for youngsters, they only see this. Mm-hmm. Those people are the wrong example for society, not me. Because mm-hmm. I see over the physical. They don't see over the physical, and that's where the danger is.
Yeah. So what would you say your prescription for happiness and self-love would be? If you had to prescribe something to somebody, what would it be?
Be truth to yourself. Mm-hmm. Be truth to your beliefs. And don't try to be something that you're not. Mm-hmm.
You're very black and white.
Yes. I'm very black and white. I'm very honest. I'm very right there, yes.
Do you ever get, I'm sure you do, and I think that maybe it's a cultural thing, that people say that maybe you're a little bit cold. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I have a friend.
I think it's my face. I believe no. I believe it's my face because it's so bony and it's all. It's always like so, like you know, and my eyebrows and I really believe so. And I don't smile because of my teeth.
Because
so
you have strong features.
Yes. Okay. And I'm always serious.
Okay.
So people think that I'm not approachable.
But you
I
are.
Do not
you
mind.
Are.
I do not mind. Also because I also, like, when people think that I'm not approachable, like, I don't get, like, too many people around me.
Okay.
The good and the bad.
Okay.
So the bad, I, like, you know what I mean. Mm-hmm. But, yeah, I do get that a lot.
Filipino culture have made us a little bit softer from where we've come from and how we were raised. But I think that is a classic example of, you know, positivity breeds positivity, kindness breeds kindness. And the Filipino culture and the race were such kind, warm, patient, compassionate people
it's so
hard to not be infected by it. Mm-hmm. And then you said at the beginning of the episode that you think it's very important to make sure that you love yourself, but mm-hmm. love yourself right so that you can love other people, because you can't love other people if you're not loving yourself.
Exactly.
So I think if anything in this whole interview, that is the main message that I've kind of gotten from you, because I mean, look at your family unit. There's you and your two kids and your husband. And when anything goes wrong, and quote me if I'm wrong, you guys all turn to each other.
Exactly.
You know, when tough times come, when bad times come, but even when good times come, you know, you celebrate with each other, you lean on each other. Mm-hmm. And that's what a family is.
We are very down-to-earth people, and mm-hmm. we are like non-material people. Like, we really want to raise our kids with all the experience that they can get. Mm-hmm. Like, for us, it's not about having this or that. It's really the experience that we can provide her. So for us, if we have to choose in between making money or spending time with her, but still, of course, we have to give her a good life,
of course,
we will go for having the most of the time that we can to spend with her, yes. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I ask all of my guests to bring in something sentimental or something that they can't leave home without. Mm-hmm. Did you bring anything in for me today?
So I was thinking, what can I bring? And I really am not attached to anything material. Mm-hmm. So the only thing that I cannot leave my home without right now, it's my 2-month-old baby, Kenzo.
So yeah, that's why I brought.
You brought him in, but he's sleeping at the moment, yes. Right? So okay, well, thank you so much, and I understand the attachment. Thank you so much.
I really appreciate it.